Okay, you ready? Bring this council meeting to order. Would you please all rise for the singing of our national anthem, followed by a moment of personal reflection. Welcome, everybody, to our regular council meeting of May 6, 2015. All members of council are present today. I wish to remind everyone who's joining us, if you would please ensure that all your cell phones and your electronic devices are turned off or placed in a non-audible mode during the meeting. Earlier at 12 noon today, City Council started the meeting to consider closed session business as permitted by Council's procedural bylaw. Council starts and ends all of its meetings in public session. At the time of the starting of the meeting in public session, Council passed a motion to approve the agenda for today's meeting, and I will ask the clerk to read the motion that carried on the approval of the agenda.
Through you, Mayor Jeffrey, the following motion was carried, that the agenda for the regular meeting of May 6, 2015 be approved as amended to the following two additions. Item U8, closed session, personnel matters about an identifiable individual, including local board or municipal employees. Item P1, new business, election to the Federation of Canadian Municipalities Board of Directors for the 2015 to 2018 term of council. In addition, Mayor Jeffrey, there were minutes, item C2 of the special council meeting of May 4th that were distributed to members, as well as closed session items U4 and U5, U4 being minutes of the closed session of the Citizen Appointments Committee from April 28th and 30th, 2015, and U5 is a report from the City Clerk's Office regarding citizen appointments that deal with identifiable individuals.
Thank you, Mr. Clerk. Before moving into closed session, Council also considered any declarations of pecuniary interest under the Municipal Conflict of Interest Act for any matter to be considered on today's agenda. Mr. Clerk, can you please advise whether any declarations of interest were made by members?
Through you, Mayor Jeffrey, to Council, two declarations of interest were declared at the start of the meeting, one by Councillor Moore in regard to closed session item U7, as Councillor Moore is a member of Council from the former term of office for City Council, and in terms of Councillor Gibson declared a conflict of interest with respect to item U7, closed session, as he was a member of Council of the former term of office for City Council.
Thank you. Council then moved a motion to move into closed session to consider business. It is permitted to do so under the Municipal Act as listed on today's meeting agenda under item U. We considered one of eight items in the course of closed session, and we will be returning to in-camera following the meeting, so we won't be able to report in the public session any outcomes of today's closed meeting until we've completed those other items. We're now at item C of the adoption of the minutes. We have minutes that are moved by Councillor Dillon and Councillor Gibson with regards to the minutes of April 22nd to the council meeting of May 6th be approved as printed and circulated, and that the special city council meeting of May 4th to the city council meeting of May 6th be approved as printed and circulated. All those in favor? All those opposed? That's carried. We're now ready to move to the next item of public business on today's council agenda, item C. We have two sets of council minutes from our previous meetings. Oh, I just did that. Sorry. We're at the consent? Okay. The items listed with an asterisk on the agenda are considered to be routine and non-controversial. The consent motion is to adopt the matter on today's agenda without need for a separate discussion on the item unless a member requests a separate discussion. Does any member wish to add or subtract from the consent agenda? I have a motion by Councillor Gibson, seconded by Councillor Miles. Council approves the following items, and that the various officials of the corporation are hereby authorized to take directed to take action as may be necessary. All those in favor? All those opposed? That's carried. We now move to the part of the agenda dealing with announcements. Council, today we have five announcements. Each announcement requires a sponsor from a member of council, and the sponsoring member is permitted a moment to introduce the matter before the person comes forward to make the announcement, and at the end of each announcement, only the meeting chair or the sponsoring member should respond on behalf of council. With your indulgence, council, we're going to go to E2, which is the announcement with regards to National Public Works Week, which is May 22nd to 19th to 22nd. The council sponsor is Councillor Moore. Did you want to make a comment? Okay. So I think Joe Petushka, you wanted to make an announcement before Mr. Ron Landry comes forward.
Thank you, Madam Mayor, members of council. Rod Landry is here with his team. This is a team that's doing community outreach from the public works point of view. Public works sometimes are taken for granted. Everybody uses public works every day in their lives, whether they walk on a sidewalk or drive on a street, or a street light comes on at night, snow is cleared in the wintertime, and to bring to the public's attention the kind of work that the public works entails and what they do and how they do it. This group of individuals have been planning this event for some time, a lot of it on their own time, and Rod Landry is the chair for the second year in a row. Rod is the supervisor at the Williams Parkway Yard, and he's got his team here with their colorful t-shirts. Here they are. And I ask all of council and citizens to participate, and there are some events that Rod's going to get into in a minute. And I'd just like to say that this is Rod's second year as chairman, and that last year the city of Brampton, under his leadership, won the OPWA Bruce Brunton Award for the best public works presentation in all of Ontario. So we're very happy to have Rod and his team, and hopefully we can not only win the Ontario one, but the national one. By the way, we would have won the national one last year, but we were just a little late with our submission. But so we're going to try a little harder this year to get it in on time. So with that, Rod?
So I just want to alert council that following the presentation, there's a desire to have a picture with your t-shirt so that we can brag about the work that you do. And Rod, I guess you're a glutton for punishment to do this 2 years in a row. Welcome to you and your team.
Mr. Jeffrey, members of council and executive leadership team. My name is Rod Landry, and I am the operations supervisor in maintenance and operation. I'm also the chair of the city's National Public Works Week Committee. This is an annual celebration of the people who build and maintain roads, sidewalks, parks, and more. Our team has worked hard to keep Brampton moving, and we would like to share our work with colleagues and residents. We've been celebrating in Brampton for well over a decade, and we have won top honors for both the Canadian Public Works Association and Ontario Public Works Association numerous times. In particular, both organizations have commended us for the way we reached out to students of all ages. And we hold career forums in local high schools. We bring kindergarten students to our operation yards to learn about roads and park maintenance. We also take a grade 4 class out to plant trees and learn about stormwater ponds. And every year, we ask local students in grade 1 to 3 to draw pictures of what Public Works means to them. I'm pleased to present this year's winner, and this is Cheyenne Ezenlue, which is, Cheyenne is right here. He's a grade 2 student from St. Josephine's Catholic Elementary School. You can see on your t-shirts, he did a great job showing the importance of public works that we do in Brampton. We're so glad that he could be here with us today. Our celebration will kick off this Tuesday, May 19th, with a flag raising ceremony at City Hall. You've got a copy of this week's event in front of you, and it's also available on our website. Mayor Jeffrey and members of council, we thank you for your support of this celebration and having us here today. We look forward to seeing you at our events. Thank you.
Okay, Councillor Moore.
Thank you, and I'd like to extend appreciation on behalf of the mayor and members of council for all the work that the committee does. For the new members of council, this is a really exciting week. You know, the fact that you've been recognized for the work that you do is a testament to that, but I encourage all the new folks to participate, come out and watch the, you're doing the bus pull again?
Yes.
All right.
Yeah, that's a fun day for everyone.
Yeah, it's a fun day. It's a sore day the next day for many of them, but
yes.
I want to recognize Cheyenne. Well, they always say the apple doesn't fall too far from the tree. Who do you get your artistic ability from, your mom or your dad?
Mom.
Your mom. Well, congratulations to you. I can't imagine how neat it feels just to have all these people wearing t-shirts with a picture that you have created for not just our staff, but for the citizens of the city of Brampton to enjoy and appreciate. So thank you very much.
Thank you. So we're going to come to you and we'll take a picture and thank you. We're very proud of the work that you do, and I know many of us, if not all of us, will come out and support your event. So thank you.
Thank you.
So, Council, let's go take a picture.
Take your t-shirt with you.
Cheyenne, congratulations. Beautiful picture.
Can you just put that on the record?
For our picture, okay?
What? I'll step up for you.
You want to bring it
back?
Hire that person.
I'm taller than you.
Thank you.
Okay, Council, when we get back to our agenda, we're going to go to E5, which is the announcement with regards to the 10th anniversary of the Brampton Call Center. Our council sponsor is Councillor Moore. Did you want to make a comment at the end, Councillor Moore? Okay. So, joining us today is Rhonda Singo, Director, Service Brampton, to make the announcement. And come on down. And thank you for the cake and your and happy anniversary.
Well, thank you. If I can, Madam Mayor, just before Rhonda gets started, yesterday you and I and Councillor Gibson and Councillor Bowman had a pleasure of visiting and enjoying the cake and the other sweets that were there. I'm not sure it was the healthiest lunch I've had this week, but it was very nice to get to meet the staff and the work environment for our call center that began in 2005 as a very small operation providing services for a limited number of hours, for a limited number of services across the city. And when we look at it today, providing 724 coverage and actually what is an incredible workspace out there, and obviously a very positive work environment, and I think a reflection of the leadership at the top that you and Michelle and the other supervisors in your office provide. I think it's something that we all need to hold up as a real success story here in the city of Brampton, providing services 150 languages. That is really incredible that we're able to meet such a broad spectrum of our residents that live in the city. They can call the 311 and get services that they or access to the services information they need. So I want to offer congratulations on behalf of the mayor and members of council. 10 years is seems like it flew by, actually, but tremendous growth, and as I said yesterday, you make us look good. So thank you.
Thank you, Councillor Moore. Madam Mayor, councillors, and executive leadership team, we really want to thank you very much for your support of our 10th anniversary celebration yesterday, but more importantly, for your commitment, your continued commitment to customer service, which is really evidenced by the continued development of our operation over the years and even what's currently happening. We've definitely grown from humble beginnings, as been brought out. We were after hours only, to now a Service Brampton division that is operating a full-fledged contact center, which means that we're managing over 400,000 different customer interactions annually over the phone, via email, online, and in person. I do have members of the Service Brampton leadership team here with me today, and we're really excited to share our plans on how we will manage our service peaks during the month of May in particular. May is one of the busiest months in terms of activities at the contact center. Basically, with the warmer weather, people are out and about a lot more, and as a result, they are in touch with the city. They're seeing issues that need to be addressed, whether it be at the roads or parks, in terms of maintenance. There's more animals out, so as well, there's animal services calls are on the increase, as well as bylaw enforcement. And there are programs that the city offers as well during May that bring up more interactions than usual. One of them is fireworks permitting. Our overdue tax notices are sent out during the month of May. And the Rose Theater launches its season. This year, we are, as usual, we're planning to have all hands on deck on the front line. Our awesome team is available 24/7 as usual. But for the Rose Theater in particular, for that launch, we've partnered even closer than usual with the box office team on an initiative that we're really excited about. We're actually going to start the launch a little bit earlier than usual. Typically it's 8 a.m. We're actually, I'm not going to say the time, but we're going earlier so that we can manage the call volumes a little bit more distributed throughout the day. And we're adding extra seats in a temporary location for a pop-up call center is what we're calling it. So there'll be 10 more folks on the phones from the box office and the Service Brampton team working together. And similarly, on the in-person service, the team is going to work together at the Rose Theater box office, mimicking the type of service that we offer at Service Brampton. So a concierge type of service where we're approaching people, expediting through so that our patrons can get served and get their tickets for the shows that are important to them. So we're really excited about that as being proactive planning. And as well, later this year, there's some exciting new additions that are coming in terms of customer service for our citizens. We'll be launching a mobile app. We will have an automated callback feature enabled at the contact center. And as well, we're going to pilot an online agent chat on the city's website. So we're pleased to be celebrating 10 years of customer service, and we can't wait for the next 10. Thank you so much for your support.
Happy anniversary. Happy birthday. Thank you. I look forward to working with you.
Thank you.
Our next item is for the Brampton Sports Hall of Fame inductees. Councillor Williams is the council sponsor for this announcement. Joining us today, I believe, is Dean McLeod, chair of the Brampton Sports Hall of Fame committee, to announce our new inductees. Mr. McLeod, come on up. Councillor Williams.
Yeah, welcome, Dean.
Thank you, Doug.
It says here on the agenda, 2 minute maximum.
Well, I see 3:52 up here, so.
So there's a clock up there for you. Go ahead, Dean. Thanks, buddy.
No heckling the guests. Welcome.
Thank you. Madam Mayor, councillors, it is my pleasure to represent our Sports Hall of Fame committee. The 35th time that we've done an induction. It'll be next Tuesday night at the Rose Theater. And we have a poster that has been prepared. I believe that Councillor Bowman was instrumental in getting this prepared. But the four new inductees for this year is Jason Bent, a longtime Bramptonian, professional, World Cup soccer player currently. And by the way, I tried to get all four here, and because of doctor's appointments and Jason coaching with TFC, our lacrosse player was seeing my surgeon with shoulder problems, a good friend of Doug's, and Stephanie, unfortunately, in Whitehorse, where she resides now, was concussed in a car accident about 2 months ago, and she wanted to be here. She's in town now, but she's still not feeling 100%, but she will be at the induction ceremony. So just going forward, our next inductee is Stephanie. This is a very, very important inductee to us, as all of them are. But Stephanie is a Bramptonian. She was born with one leg and one hip, began swimming, and is now the second most decorated Olympian in Canadian history. She's a Bramptonian. She's captured in three Olympics, the past three, 19 medals, 7 gold, 10 silver, and 2 bronze, and I hope you all can come out and meet her next Tuesday night. Reggie Yules, a personal friend of mine, grew up playing lacrosse, but he saw his niche in coaching and was very, very instrumental in the development of ladies lacrosse. And ladies lacrosse is, right now in Canada, the highest growing discipline of our sport. And last is Nancy Whiteford, who has coached figure skating in Brampton, still participates in Masters, and it's to be known that two of our past inductees are students of Nancy's. I've met them all. They are all very proud to join the 176 past inductees in our Hall of Fame, and as I said, the ceremony is next Tuesday night across the street at the Rose Theater. There's been an invitation to all the councillors and you, Madam Mayor. We're hoping that every one of you can come out and enjoy the evening, because believe me, from a person who's gone through it, it's a once-in-a-lifetime thing, and the town support, and going to the town support, I can't be here without thanking council for their ongoing financial support to put this event on. So. In closing, thank you very much for allowing us 3 minutes and 10 seconds. That's short for me. I told I was going to get the hook, but thank you very much, and I hope to see you all next Tuesday night. Thanks, Doug.
Thank you. Doug, did you want to add anything?
Maybe just touch on the two keynote speakers we have, the MC.
By all means.
The committee did an excellent job in getting these two gentlemen.
Yes. Yes. First of all, the MC is a Mr. Pat Boland. I don't know Pat myself, but he comes highly recommended by one of our other committee members. The chair of the subcommittee interviewed him, thought he was the one, and came with the recommendation. We have brought Pat on, and I'm waiting to meet him and hear him. He's done that position in the past, and I expect that he'll do a bang-up job for us. The keynote speaker is you turn on the basketball game. I watched him on TSN last night, Rod Black, a very, very accomplished sports announcer in the city of Toronto and across Canada. Rod is the fee that we're paying him. He is donating back $500 to our Hall of Fame, and we are very, very excited to have Rod, and it was instrumental. Rod's coming on board was very instrumental through the city of Brampton too, Doug, as you alluded to. So we're thrilled that each year the ceremony gets bigger and better. And I talked to Dennis just before the proceeding started today, and the last 2 years I've been on the committee for I believe 12 or 13 or 14 years now, but the last committee, and especially the last 2 years, is the finest committee that we have had. And we've got Norman and of course Supa from the city of Brampton here as a little support. Being a noon hour and during the week, it's tough to get people here, but they all send their regrets, but they'll all be there on Tuesday night. So, thank you.
Thank you very much. This is a beautiful poster. This is a great teaser for next week. I'm looking forward to it. I'll see you then.
You're going to be there?
Yes, I am.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks, Councillor.
Thanks, everybody. Okay. Our next announcement is for the Royal Life Saving Society Commonwealth Service Awards to Public Services staff. Councillor Dillon is the council sponsor. Joining us today is Donna Lynn Rosa, Director of Recreation Culture, to introduce our Commonwealth Service Award recipients.
Madam Mayor, members of council, executive leadership team, it's my thrill to be here to bring a good news story to you. Last month, four City of Brampton staff members were recognized for their contributions to the Life Saving Society. It was at an investiture service at Queen's Park, and the Lieutenant Governor presented their award, so it was a pretty big deal. The Society is a charitable organization working to prevent drowning and water-related injury through training programs, water smart public education, safety management services, drowning prevention research, and life-saving sport. Today, I would like to acknowledge Juanita Bushleb, Merrick Holk, Scott Bilodeau, and Joey Rushneck for their volunteer work that they do. So this is beyond their jobs here. It's their volunteer work with the Society. So I'll invite Juanita Bushleb up to start. Juanita was recognized for the energy and dedication she brings to the success of the Life Saving Society's drowning prevention mission. Her recent accomplishments include holding the position as the Society's past president, a member of the National Board of Directors. She also chairs Life Saving Society's Ontario National Relations and Nominations Committees. For her service to the Society, Juanita was honored with the Bar to Service Cross. And this comes with great honor, and congratulations, Juanita. I'd also like to invite up, to invite up Mr. Merrick Holk. Merrick was recognized as an enthusiastic life-saving sport organizer and experienced official at Ontario Championships. He is enthusiastic and thoughtful volunteer leader who is always supportive of the contribution of others. For Merrick's continued dedication to drowning prevention program, Merrick was presented with the Life-Saving Society Service Medal. Congratulations, Merrick. I'd like to invite up Mr. Scott Bilodeau. Scott is an instructor and an examiner in the Society's swim, life-saving, first aid, and National Lifeguard programs. He is an experienced life-saving sport official, announcer, event coordinator, jack of all trades. Basically, he's a trainer of everything for the Life-Saving Society. This includes his role as social media chair on the Public Education Council. Scott was presented with his service medal for the continued volunteer contributions to the Society. Congratulations, Scott. And finally, I'd like to ask Mr. Joey Rusnak to join us. Joey is a swim, life-saving, first aid, and national lifeguard instructor, trainer. He is an aquatic supervisor, instructor, and sea auditor, S-E-E. For his enthusiastic contributions, the Society recognized Joey with the Service Commendation. Congratulations, Joey. As I mentioned, all of these people who are employees of the city and at one time all worked in recreation, not all of them are with us right now, they all started as, wait for it, part-timers. So the value of our part-timers, and look at the awards that they're bringing. They're representing us on a provincial and a national level. They're representing Brampton, and I am so incredibly proud to call them co-workers and to say that while they're out there on their own time and their passion for what they do, it truly is an example to all of us. So thank you for acknowledging them, and I think we should give them one more hand.
Councillor Dillon.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. I just want to just commend everybody today. I want to commend you as well, Donalyn, for your hard work and your whole entire team. But you know what you guys do is amazing, and I think it's great. And I think it's just indicative of the atmosphere we have within the city and the people we hire. I think that also reflects the city as a whole as well. So once again, I just really want to thank and I want to commend you as well for all your hard work. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Are we waiting for a picture? Is that, I see somebody.
I see the photographer. That would be great if you could.
Councillor Dillon and I to come down?
Please do.
I just wanted to say thank you. What you're doing is commendable. We stand on your shoulders and you make Brampton proud. Thank you.
Thank you.
If we could invite our chair, maybe.
Our next announcement is for the Brampton Arts and Venture Program Educators Open House May 15th. Councillor Gibson is the council sponsor for this announcement. Joining us again is Donna Lynn Rosa, Director of Recreation and Culture, to make the announcement. Councillor Gibson, did you want to start?
Yeah, maybe I can introduce Donna Lynn. I'm very pleased as Chair of Community and Public Services to sponsor this one to be on the agenda and just ask Donna Lynn to give us a little highlight of it, please.
Madam Mayor, members of council, executive leadership team. I was going to present the date that we would be having this event, but in light of the recent strikes and pending strikes, we've had to put a hold on things. But I will tell you that we have held this event in the past where we invite the teachers and the administrators of all the schools to the Rose Theater. And in one afternoon, we sell out almost 60% of our tickets for the daytime programming. So during the day, especially at the end of the, you'll start to see the buses coming out to the Rose Theater, and you'll see the young kids going in. So we have the theater filled with school children, and this is all sold generally on this one night. This year, I believe we were about 95% sold out for this program. The staff have worked together with the recreation folks to also upsell recreation opportunities. So we will be postponing the event. However, I will come back with a date when we know more about the strikes.
Thank you. Okay, Council, we're at the point of our agenda of delegations. We have no delegations on today's agenda. There's no item under G, H, or I. We're at committee reports for this item J. We have five sets of minutes today. Under Council's meeting procedure, the committee chair introduces their committee report or minutes and summarizes the matters considered that are now being brought forward for today for ratification. Councilor Moore, you chaired Planning and Infrastructure Services Committee meeting on April 27th. This is item J1. I now pass the chair to you, lead counsel, in the consideration of the committee minutes.
Thank you very much, Madam Mayor. Members of Council, you have the minutes and recommendations from the Planning and Infrastructure Services Committee. Are there any questions or comments? Seeing none, I'll turn them back to you for ratification, Madam Mayor.
Thank you, Councilor Moore. Moved by Councilor Moore, seconded by Councilor Dillon, that the minutes of the Planning and Infrastructure Service Committee meeting of April 27th be received and the recommendations be approved. All those in favor? All those opposed? That's carried. Councilor Willens, you chaired the Citizens Appointment Committee held on April 28th and 30th, and this is item J2. I pass the chair to you to lead council in consideration of the committee minutes.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. You have the minutes in front of you. Are there any questions? We can't make any recommendations, unfortunately, because we have to do this, show the names of the selection in closed sessions. So there's no recommendations for this meeting.
But we will be reporting later today.
Yes. Yeah.
So just hang in there. We'll get to it. So I have a motion by Councilor Willens, second by Councilor Moore, that the minutes be received and the recommendations be approved as outlined in the subject minutes. All those in favor? All those opposed? That's carried. Councilor Gibson, you chaired Community and Public Services Committee meeting on April 29th. This is item J3. I pass the chair to you to lead council in consideration of the committee minutes.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. Council, you have the Community and Public Services minutes in front of you of April 29th. Are there any questions or comments? Seeing none of the board, Madam Mayor, I pass them back to you for ratification.
Thank you. Moved by Councilor Dillon, seconded by Councilor Gibson. The minutes of the Community and Public Services Committee meeting of April 29th be received. Recommendations be approved as outlined in the subject minutes. All in favor? All opposed? That's carried. Councilor Bowman, you chaired Economic Development Committee on April 29th. This is item J4. I now pass the chair to you to lead council in consideration of the committee minutes.
Thank you very much, Madam Mayor. Item J4, you've all got the minutes in front of you from April 29th, 2015, the minutes and recommendations. Is there any questions? Seeing none, I pass back to you, Madam Mayor, for ratification.
Thank you. I have a motion by Councilor Bowman, seconded by Councilor Miles. Minutes of Economic Development Committee meeting of April 29th be received and the recommendations be approved as outlined in the subject minutes. All in favor? All opposed? That's carried. Councilor Medeiros, you chaired Corporate Services Committee meeting on April 29th. This is item J5. I now pass the chair to you to lead council in consideration of the committee minutes.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. Fellow councillors, you have before you the minutes from Corporate Services Committee meeting April 29th. Are there any comments or questions? Nope. Back to you, Madam Mayor.
Thank you. Motion by Councilor Medeiros, second by Councilor Gibson, that the minutes of the Corporate Services Committee meeting of April 29th be received and that the recommendations be approved as outlined in the subject minutes. All in favor? All opposed? That's carried. We have an item on our agenda that was added earlier, which is P1. This is new business that Councillor Dillon added, and we have a motion. I don't know if you want to speak to it, Councillor Dillon.
Thank you very much, Madam Mayor. My fellow councillors know, I was part of the FCM, the Federation of Canadian Municipalities Board of Directors. I had the privilege of serving the remainder of the last term. Just for those who don't know, the FCM is the National Voice of Municipalities. They advocate the needs of these municipalities, which are reflected in federal policies and programs. It was a great experience for me personally because of the knowledge gained in trying to make our city a better place for our residents, not only now but for future generations of Bramptonians as well. So I look for your support and confidence today in running for re-election for the Board of Directors.
So, Council, you have the motion in front of you, but I'm happy to read it. Whereas the Federation of Canadian Municipalities, FCM, represents the interests of municipalities on policy and program matters, fall within the federal jurisdiction, and whereas FCM's Board of Directors comprised of elected municipal officials from all regions and sizes of communities to form a broad base of support and provide FCM with the prestige required to carry the municipal message to the federal government. And whereas FCM has called for council members from Ontario to fill vacancies on the Board of Directors for the 2015 to 2018 term, be it resolved that the Council of the Corporation of the City of Brampton endorse Councillor Gurpreet Dillon to stand for election on FCM's Board of Directors for the 2015 to 2018 term, and be it further resolved that all incurred expenses associated with Councillor Gurpreet Dillon's attending FCM's Board of Directors meetings be funded from the current budget corporate initiatives account for corporate representation on municipal business for 2015 and subsequent years, subject to approval as part of the annual budget process. Councillor Dillon, did you want to say anything else?
No, I think I said
Okay. Councillor Gibson.
Yeah, a question to clerk. I thought we already did this.
Through you, Mayor Jeffrey, it was done on December 10th, council, but it was only done for the year 2015.
Also, wasn't for the term?
It was filling in a vacancy, and now that the FCM is looking for board members for the remainder of the term.
I thought we had appointed him for the term. Okay.
Councillor Medeiros.
Thank you, through Madam Chair. First, I'd like to recognize Councillor Dillon's efforts in participating in FCM. I think it's a worthy cause. He has my full support. I would also just like to make an appeal to my colleagues, because I do understand that there's another councillor from Peel Region who's interested in the board position, I believe from the City of Mississauga. So I would hope that council colleagues will support Councillor Dillon by forms of lobbying and letting know his interest. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. You just have to register when we get the registration up. But until then, we support Brampton. Any other comments or questions? Seeing none, all those in favor? All those opposed? That's carried. We're at item R, which is the Regional Council Business, the Region Appeal Emergency Management Program Committee. It's meeting tomorrow, May 7th. Deborah Reeder is here. She's distributed a briefing note on that committee agenda to all members yesterday. And she's here to answer any questions you might have about the matter. Are there any questions? You did such a good job that...
I have a few notes, if okay. I may, Madam Mayor.
Go ahead. Sure.
Good afternoon, Madam Mayor and members of council and executive leadership team. Just as a quick update, there are two committee meetings tomorrow, audit and risk from 11 to 12:30, emergency management program committee from 1 until 3. For the Audit and Risk Committee agenda, I'd like you to know that Catherine Spence, our City's Director of the Internal Audit, did review the agenda and its reports, and she advised that the reports have been performed as to the standards of internal auditing. For the Emergency Management Program Committee, there is one delegation and three reports for consideration. Fire Chief Clark has reviewed the reports, and he advises that he concurs with the Regional Fire Coordinator's annual report. And just to let you know, in regards to the region's information report on the emergency management for the Pan Am Pan Para Games, that Brampton does not have involvement because we're not hosting any events, but we have been, our staff has been working with the region, and should we need to be backup for Mississauga and Caledon, Brampton is on board for that. I would like to bring your attention to the delegation and the supporting report for emergency management. Mr. Barry Owens is a director for the provincial response from the Office of the Ontario Fire Marshal. He's going to be presenting to the committee tomorrow about the Ontario Emergency Management and Civil Protection Act and the rules for elected officials. There was not a presentation that was circulated with the agenda, but there was a staff report speaking to the activities for 2014. So I have asked Alain Normand, our manager of emergency measures, to speak to you about the delegation tomorrow and some issues that are pertinent for Brampton.
Welcome, Alain.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Madam Mayor. Happy to meet you, particularly on this week, Emergency Preparedness Week in Brampton in Canada. And I do want to take the occasion to thank all the members for participating in our social media event and taking pictures with our B-Mobile, which we're very proud of. The social media campaign is going very well. We're getting a lot of tweets back, so it's going on fine. About the meeting tomorrow, I just wanted to raise a couple of issues that I think the councillors that are going to be on the committee in particular should be aware of. We have had some delegations to the province because we have some concerns with the existing legislation that we would like to see addressed, and maybe this would be a good occasion to bring it up again. One of them is that the fact that all municipalities in Ontario must follow exactly the same programs means a lot of duplication when you're dealing with two-tiered municipalities. The Region Appeal and the City of Brampton, along with Mississauga and Caledon, all have to do public education, emergency public education programs. For us, this is a duplication because the region is now obligated to do exactly the work that we're doing in the City of Brampton and Mississauga, Caledon as well. We are looking at, isn't there ways that we could do partnership which would still make us compliant under the legislation, but at the same time reduce our needs for having this kind of duplication. So if the City of Brampton has an extensive emergency public education program, we've actually won awards for it, and we want to continue that. However, the Region Appeal is much better positioned to do some of the training programs. They have done training, extensive training for police in particular, which is a very large force, which they are very successful at doing this. They have done it for the paramedics, they've done it for some of the social services and public health staff. Why couldn't we piggyback on their programs and have City of Brampton staff being trained through the region where while we are doing the public education? If this kind of partnership and agreement would be accepted by the province, it would reduce our duplication and still maintain our compliance to all of the programs within the whole of the region globally. We're asking that this be raised again, if possible, tomorrow. The other thing is that the legislation has very limited flexibility when it comes to some of the training and exercise we do. In Brampton, emergency management, emergency response is an operational issue. We ask staff to respond to an emergency operations center. It is not a strategic accomplishment. It's really the people that need to be at the operations center are the directors and managers, and those are the people that we're constantly working with to train. But unfortunately, the legislation forces us to train senior management, who are already very busy with lots of portfolios, and including the CEO, and it's a difficult task, which we find is not really necessary. We do keep our CEO and our executive leadership team involved and informed, but we don't need to have them come and take a full day of training every year in emergency management when actually they're not the ones that are going to be called in to respond. We need the directors and the managers at the table. So we're asking that there be some flexibility brought into the legislation for this kind of thing. And a third element that we'd like to is concerning the role of the Region Appeal, particularly in questions of debris management. During the ice storm, we struggled because we were expecting the waste management contract and the waste management functions that are normally to be held by the Region Appeal to be done, and unfortunately we had absolutely none of that service available to us, and citizens were told that they had to cut branches into 4 feet length and wrap them up in bundles of 30 kilograms, which was totally unacceptable to us. So we did the work. We took this on our own at the City of Brampton, and our people from the parks operation in particular did a fabulous job in cleaning up, but it took us a long time and it cost a lot of money, and we didn't have that support. We don't want to go into the next emergency without knowing exactly what is our position and what is the position of the Region Appeal regarding the whole disaster recovery aspect and the debris management. We want to have clear answers as to what to expect so that if we're not going to get the services, then we know what kind of plan we need to develop. We need your support on this. Since it's going to be brought up tomorrow on the report on the ice storm, I would appreciate having your support. We've had great support from council in the past, and we appreciate that very much.
Thank you very much. Councillor Gibson.
Mr. Acting Mayor. Elaine, have you put those concerns in writing to the region yet?
We have had many talks over the years of the region, and I work closely with the Emergency Management Office, and they understand, apparently, they have some difficulties in getting some of the other players at the table, and we haven't been able to have any kind of negotiated discussion with, in particular, the waste management. In passing, the decision not to participate came directly from the chair of the region at the time.
Yeah, the issue of the roles of the region in emergencies, I've already talked to David Schwartzbrook as a representative from Brampton Emergency Preparedness, and he was going to have somebody contact you about that. I'm not sure if you did or not.
I haven't received
any. Not yet? Oh, well. The other training thing, and I'm not sure, maybe I can ask council, I'm not sure who the council rep is from the region on emergency preparedness. You, Michael, is it you?
Sorry.
At the region for emergency preparedness. Okay, well, maybe we can find out for sure. And could you put those concerns in writing? Because, I mean, I'm going to be there tomorrow, but I'm not part of the committee.
Right.
When they ask for people from the, although I'm the rep here, when they ask for a representative there, they only wanted one from Brampton, and I didn't want to oppose my own people from Brampton. So I, you know, so maybe if you can put something to that effect in writing to, if it's Michael, then to Michael. And the other, I don't, you know, the other members that are going to be there tomorrow, then maybe Michael can bring it up, and and then we can. You know, I'll be there too to support them, but I'm not. I don't really, I don't know if I have a vote tomorrow, so I'll be there, but I don't. I'm not part of the committee. So.
Okay.
If you can do
appreciate
that. Would be
appreciate
great.
That. Yeah.
Thank
sure.
you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor Gibson. Councillor Pelosi, did you want
to? Yeah, I was just on to say that myself and
those are both on the committee.
Thank you very much. Okay.
Thank you, Councillor Pelosi. Thank you very much. So we'll take that under advisement. Please, yep, Ms. Reeder.
I'm sorry. I just wanted to remind you that the briefing note that I circulated yesterday afternoon does contain the issue, the background, and the particular questions that Alain has posed today. I can recirculate it again if you didn't see that. So, all right. Thank you.
Yep. It would be helpful if we had something, not just all the briefing notes. It's very difficult for us at the region just to take briefing notes and say, here they are. It's better if we can have something in particular to that item that the members at that time can put forward to the committee. If you understand what I'm saying? Is that possible?
Councillor Gibson, are you referring to maybe a motion or comments prepared? Or?
Something like that you guys as members of the committee put forward to the committee to say, I'm disappointed to hear that they haven't already talked to Elaine about the response of the region, because I was told they would like 3 months ago. But at least we had something that they put in committee, then it's in the minutes, and it's not just a briefing note on all this stuff, it's in particular the emergency preparedness stuff.
So, Mr. Chair, just so that I'm clear, in the briefing note, it does say the particular question to the delegation tomorrow that Alain would like you to ask for the two first issues. For the one on the ice storm, we've written out two directions that we would like you to give to staff. Now, if you would prefer that we put that in a notice of motion that you could submit, I could certainly do that.
Councillor Pelosi?
Yeah, I'm okay with that, or we pass something here today now to bring forward for tomorrow's committee. Want to write up a motion? I'll second it.
Well, I think, sorry to just intervene, but the briefing note does have suggested comments and so on, and I think if we can relay those comments at the committee, and at that time we can maybe put a motion at the committee. I think that'd probably be appropriate.
And assure you, Mr. Chair, I will be at the meeting to assist with the drafting of a motion if you decide to do that.
Fantastic. Maybe there can be a draft, you know, if you can bring a draft motion that maybe we can present tomorrow.
Okay.
That might be beneficial as well.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you very much, Ms.
You're welcome.
Thank you. So I have a motion here moved by Councillor Pelosi, seconded by Councillor Gibson, that the presentation by Ms. Reeder and Mr. Norman be received. All in favor? Opposed? Carried. So we're at public question period now? Excellent. So now we can deal with the public question period. This is where we invite members of the public to come forward. Are there any questions from the public today? Going once, twice. Thank you very much. We go over to bylaws. We are now at the portion of the meeting dealing with adoption of city bylaws to give effective to city council decisions made at this meeting and previous meetings. I have a motion by Councillor Dillon and seconded by Councillor Gibson to approve the bylaws. All in favor? Opposed? That carries. Our next item of business is, I believe we go back to closed session. Do we need a motion to recess? No. Okay, so we will recess then for 10 minutes, is that fair? Okay, adjourned session. Recess for closed session.